teacher, listen to your mother.
Schedule, Stacy. Next time I'm leaving without you.
Are we Mr. Grumpy this morning, Brad?
I hate it when you talk cute.
I know.
I just cleaned the upholstery. No, not on the floor.
You don't have to be so nasty. What are you, upset because you have to go to court today?
I told you not to mention that.
What, your speeding ticket? Oh, I would never mention your speeding ticket.
Okay, now just shut up about it.
Talk to me like that.
I'll talk to you any way I want.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will.
Shut up.
No, you shut up.
Real mature, Brad.
That's it. Tomorrow, you walk to school.
You know, Brad, I hope the judge locks you up forever.
Why don't you get a boyfriend already? Driving you to school every day is really killing my image.
You're the lowest, Brad.
Yeah? Well, that makes two of us.
Emotions are much like the air in this balloon. If we let them build up inside of us...
Hey, magic.
The whole point is that you've got to let your feelings out. It's the healthy thing to do, it's the right thing to do, and just, you know, to ventilate your feelings.
It's going to be an outrageous wedding day. Right on the beach, two live bands. Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Sounds great.
You going alone?
No, I really don't think so. I don't know, maybe I'll take Brad.
Brad? I thought you wanted to have a good time.
All right, I want you to write as much or as little as it takes to answer this honestly. Jeff.
What if nothing bothers you?
Oh, I mean, come on, isn't there anything that really bugs you?
John Denver.
All right, are there any other questions? No? Okay, then grab your pencils, and as we used to say, let it all hang out.
There's an empty table over there.
Rats, empty tables are for wimps. Watch this. Excuse me, ladies. Are these seats reserved?
Hi, guys. Yes, actually, they are.
Well, don't mind if we do. Rats, sit down. Your meatloaf is getting cold. So how about that assignment today? Classic melon.
Yeah, too much.
So what did you write bothers you, Barrett?
You.
Oh, come on. Now, don't be shy. You can tell us.
What did you write, Damone?
Women are just crazy about me. Oh, which is great. But still, it bothers me that there are so many women and so little time.
Mike Damone.
Who else? Oh, I am so disappointed. I wanted to find out what really bothers them.
Believe me, Leslie, you don't want to know.
Oh, they are so repressed. Look, read this, please.
It bothers me when I wear corduroy pants that make noise when my thighs rub together.
This can't be all that's on their mind.
And then I was going to write about nuclear war, but I decided to go with dandruff.
Oh, classy rap.
So what did you write about, Stacy?
I really don't remember.
It bothers me when I'm rejected by people in my own family.
Stacy Hamilton,
Hector, this is a real cry for help.
I don't know. Maybe she just had a bad day.
Never, ever, ever get involved in their personal lives.
What's wrong? Why can't a teacher help a student with a personal problem?
A, it's none of our business. And B, it's none of our business.
Yeah, well, you know, Arnold, I want the kids to know that some of us don't stop caring after the bell rings.
Let's face it, Leslie. You are a meddler, an amateur psychiatrist.
You know, the kids are right, Arnold. You can be very cruel.
Ms. Mellon, teaching is not a popularity contest.
I didn't write anything.
Stacy, this is Linda you're talking to. Come on, fess up.
Maybe I did.
What?
Overventilate a little.
Great.
Well, I wrote about this fight I had with Brad.
Stacy, you never write anything personal in Mellon class. She eats that stuff up.
Maybe she'll just forget.
Maybe not.
Stacy! Hi. Listen, hi, Linda. Can I talk to you for a moment?
I'll just be on my way.
Thanks. Listen, I want to use your composition as an example for Friday's discussion on how to deal with rejection.
Ms. Mellon, you wouldn't read it in front of the whole class.
Oh, no, I would never mention your name in class. And Stacy, listen, if you ever need me for anything, I'm here for you. Okay?
It's all over, Stace.
I'm gonna call you back, okay?
Why? Why did I speak? What was I trying to prove?
I don't know, Brad. Your masculinity?
Listen, I'm sorry I was mean to you this morning. I'll never do it again. I'll never do anything again.
What are you talking about?
The judge decided to make an example of me. Me? He suspended my license for a month.
Brad, it's only 30 days.
Only 30 days? That's one-tenth of my senior year. If it were one-tenth of my life, it would be 7 years.
Take it easy, Brad.
This is the worst thing that's ever happened to me. You can't breathe a word of this to anyone. If this gets out, I'll be the school joke.
Oh, come on. You're Brad Hamilton. You don't need a car to be a man.
Yes, I do.
Brad, I want to show you something. A customer just returned this.
What's the matter with it?
Diet special.
It's a mistake. I'll get on it right away, Dennis.
Hi, Brad.
Huh? Oh, Linda. Hi.
Hi. Listen, I need to ask you something.
Yeah, sure, but make it quick. I'm on company time.
Right. My cousin is having this big wedding, so I thought maybe you could take me.
Me?
Uh-huh. It wouldn't be like a date or anything. You would just be my escort.
Oh.
Come on, it'll be fun. It's going to be right on the beach. There's going to be two live bands, dancing. We'll have a good time. I personally guarantee it.
Sounds incredible. You got yourself an escort.
Great. You tell Mr. Cruising Vessel I'm really looking forward to the ride.
Mr. Cruising Vessel?
Uh-huh.
Hey, this wedding wouldn't be in the next 30 days, would it?
Next week.
Next week? That's 7 days. That's quick.
Uh-huh. So you better get moving. I mean, you need to rent a tux and shine up that cruising vessel.
You got it. I'll be there.
Me too. Bye, Brad.
You there? How am I going to be there? Crazy? Seven days, I could be dead.
Hamilton?
What?
What are you doing?
Hamilton on two wheels?
Oh, am I hallucinating?
Hey, so what happened, Hamilton? You seem to be minus one cruising vessel.
Wait, hey, it's in the shop, okay?
Lighten up.
So what's the problem?
Hey, Major, just a wash and a trim. But hey, why am I explaining this to you guys? I'm a senior.
She's coming. Just do it exactly the way we rehearsed, okay? Miss Mellon?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
You know, I would rather you didn't read my essay in class because I'm already in therapy for that exact problem right now.
Are you really?
Uh-huh.
Listen, Steve, if it's not too personal, can I ask what kind? Is it like a primal, family, aqua?
Well, I'm not actually in therapy.
Stacy, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. I have been in and out of therapy ever since Larry moved out on me 4 years ago, October the 14th. But it has helped me tremendously.
I'm sure it has, Miss Mellon.
You know, if this area is a little too sensitive to discuss in the classroom, I could always set up a family conference. I could sit down with you and Brad and your parents.
No. The classroom's great.
Good.
Thank you.
119. So?
Oh.
Another day, another 7250.
Hector, something's been bothering me for the past few days, and I'd like to talk to you about it, colleague to colleague.
Name it and claim it, Arnold.
It pertains to a comment made by our own Ms. Miller. Do the students actually say I'm cruel?
Arnold, we're teachers. If we took everything personally, we'd be more freaked out than the kids. On the other hand, if you're willing to risk the slings and arrows of outrageous students, go straight to the source.
What are you talking about?
Ask one of the kids.
Problem, Brad?
Oh, no, Mr. Hand, it's just a flat.
Well, hop in.
Oh, no, sir, I couldn't impose.
Brad, I insist.
No, really, Mr. Hand, I...
Hamilton, just get in the car, will you?
Yes, sir.
Just in time.
Hamilton, I need an honest opinion from a student I can trust.
Oh, you can trust me, Mr. Hand.
Do the students in this school perceive me as cruel?
No, of course not, Mr. Hand. We respect you. We think you're fair. Tough, but fair.
Thank you, Hamilton. That's what I thought.
You know, Mr. Hand, as an assistant manager of Cattleburger, I sometimes find myself in a position where an underling needs some motivation and discipline. And at those moments, I say to myself, gee, how would Mr. Hand handle this?
I'm sure you do.
Where are we going, Mr. Hand?
I've got to stop here for a minute. Sit tight. I just have to get some cat food.
No, Mr. Hand, I really don't have...
Relax. I'll be right back.
But...
Hi, Brad.
I know this car.
Oh.
Yo, Curtis, check it out. Hamilton's in the Handmobile.
What a tugboat. I can read this thing on my board.
Yeah, it's really a pig.
Hey, Spicoli, do me a favor. Tell Mr. Hand I appreciate the ride, but I'm late for work.
Got that? Where to, Mr. Hand?
Thank you.
Hi, Brad.
Hi.
Listen, I just realized the wedding doesn't even start until 8, so we may have to stay over.
You mean sleep there?
Mm-hmm. Just to be on the safe side. Pack a toothbrush.
Okay.
Okay. Well, the mall calls. Here.
Yeah, thanks.
I gotta get to work. Brad? Your car will be out of the shop by the wedding, right?
Hey, sure. No problem.
Okay. Bye.
Hey, Linda. You have yourself a great day.
So, Brad, baby. Rumor has it you need a fake license.
Stallone, this is supposed to be between you and me.
Oh, you want confidentiality. That's going to cost you extra.
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on. Hey, a guy like you taking a walk on the wild side? That's a great story.
You're the slime of the 80s, Damone. But look, I need your help, so cut me a break, okay?
It's no problem. I know a guy whose cousin friend knows a guy who... Let's just say I can do it.
Just get me that license.
Hey, Hamilton, say forgery.
Huh?
It bothers me when I'm rejected by people in my own family. My brother has a way of making me feel like a burden, like everything that happens to him is my fault. I know I won't feel like this forever, but right now it hurts.
Is everybody
not
staring
like
at me?
Burn your finger.
Stare at Barbara DeSalva.
Deep inside your heart. I don't know why he does it to me. I just know I would never do it to him.
I don't even have a brother.
People, it's not important who wrote this. What's important is how do you feel about what Miss X said? Come on. Michael, you have an opinion about everything. What? What do you think?
You want to talk about rejection? You want to talk about a father who's a washed-up astronaut who comes home every night looking for someone to take his frustration out on?
His father's a mailman.
Michael,
don't hit me.
Yeah, well, I mean, at least Damone's father comes home every night. I mean, my dad just pays somebody to come and hit us.
Well, my dad's so out of it, he goes to the wrong house to hit people.
That must be the dude that's been beating on me.
I went out with him last week.
Hey, this is better than the Breakfast Club.
Wait up.
Come on. Highly enjoyable, Miss Marilyn.
Thank you, Dale.
You did it.
Stacy? Hi. I just want to apologize that we never got around to discussing your problem.
No, it's okay. I really learned a lot from this experience.
Really? Oh, I'm so glad.
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, no, thank you, Stacy.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Brad, I'd like to get there before the honeymoon.
Just relax, sit back, enjoy the scenery.
Oh, terrific.
How are you today?
Officer, I've never been in trouble a day in my life.
Excuse me, sir. We're on our way to a wedding, so do you think we could please make this fast?
Oh, you had your signal light on for the last 3 miles?
Oh, no. I'm sorry. It'll never happen again.
Can I see your license, please?
My license? Why?
I collect them.
That's funny.
You do have a license.
Oh, sure. It's right here where I always keep it, in my wallet. That's me right there.
Looks like you saw a ghost. All right, you stay in the car. I'm going to check this through the computer.
Hamilton, I hereby sentence you to 7 years in the state penitentiary, one-tenth of your life.
Okay, I ran a check. It appears that your record is completely clean, Mr. Garcia.
It is?
So I'm going to let you off with a warning this time, but next time, keep your mind on your driving, Guillermo.
Yes, I will, and vaya con Dios, officer.
Brad, what's going on?
My license was suspended, so I got a fake one from DeMone.
You what? Are you crazy?
Hey, I did this for you. I didn't want to let you down.
Did this for me? Guillermo?
Si.
You know, we could have just taken the bus.
Yeah. Well, I guess we ought to...
move on. I think I better drive. Just relax, sit back, enjoy the scenery.
Oh, boy.
Me? Yeah. Okay, now don't touch anything
way?
Until I get in,
no,
okay,
I'm
please?
No, I'm fine. Get in the car.
Wait for me. Don't touch anything. Just wait
where's
for me,
clutch?
Okay, please?
Just, Brad, please, where's the clutch?
The clutch? What clutch? It's an automatic transmission. There is no... Get your foot off that.
I knew that.
But wait! In drive. No, you're in first. You're in first!
Sorry.
Okay, now you're in drive. Just go slowly. No, don't hit the station wagon.
I'm not hitting the station
wagon.
It's going
to be okay.
I know.
You have a license.
Yes, I have a license. Unlike
don't hit
some
these
of
cars.
Them.
Tonight, Sergeant Hooker's efforts to end the truckers' war run afoul when a new woman police commissioner comes between Hooker and his job. On T.J. Hooker at 11:05, here on Channel 4.